Super have you released time. School kick that I've been on the last few months, just listening to old school tunes, man, trying to not forget how to play them on bass, how to play them on guitar, vihuela, because this is a perishable skill, and obviously I am perishing. I don't think I was ever that good to begin with, but so another mariachi guitar cover video, Javier Solís, Esclavo Llamo. It's a pretty dope song. It's like back in the day when I was in high school playing mariachi, learning all this repertoire. Like, we would take this song out, and I'd be like, huh? What? I don't know it. It's like, I never heard of the song before. But it's definitely one of the bangers that you want to have in your, kind of like, your repertoire and be able to play it. You know, there are people who sing it in different keys. That was C minor. It's a lot of bar chords if you're a guitar player. Sometimes people write arrangements for it, and they add in a lot of diminished chords and a lot of little transitions. I'm going to talk about diminished chords later today. Because I think that's a good topic. Like, how do you read them? How do you play them? There's three different types. Where they all go. If you're playing Javier Solís tunes, I know that there's a lot of folks that don't know all the little passing tone chords in between Javier Solís arrangements, so it's really hard to just kind of fake that shit. So we're going to go over kind of what they sound like, what they look like, what they play like on guitar, and on vihuela it's even easier. So, yeah. But for this one, it's an old school bolero. A good thing about these old arrangements, and I don't want to be disrespectful, but it's a good example of playing in time. As you can probably hear in the old school recording, like I haven't taken a metronome to this thing, but I'm pretty sure they didn't play and record to a metronome. It kind of feels like they just did it in one take, and however it came out, that's how it came out. You know, in the 60s, they're recording on magnetic tape. They don't have time to be doing this over and over and over again, right? So it's a little rough doing these covers on these old recordings. I suck too, just to, you know, put that out there. So it's even harder for me to do this correctly. So if you're in the comment section, like, you know what, I already know, all right? So you make your own video and you explain this shit and leave me alone about it. So for the chords, C minor, first chord, right? Now there's two ways you can play this. You can play it, you know, straight, I guess you could say, without the 5 of 5 transitions, right? Because you're going... the dominant 7 of every progression, of every chord in the progression. So I guess a lot of times people in mariachi groups will say just play it straight, and what they mean is don't play those passing notes, right? So that's playing it straight, right? That's not my saying, that's what people have always said to me in a gig, right? I guess you could play it not so straight. I don't really know what that means, but you can play it with the embellishments, the fancier way, right? And when you're doing that, you're doing C minor, F7 to B flat, E flat 7, right, to A flat 7, and then D7 to G7. So it's really cool, old theory. If you're a theory person and you study guitar theory and classical theory, what's basically going on there in a minor key, you can do 5 of 5 to 5 transitions. Yeah, I think I said that right. So it's a kind of a jazz thing where you have this scale of shifting 5-7 chords, dominant 7 chords. You're going da 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 all the way till you get to the dominant of your key, which is minor, C minor. If you're a theory person, you understood what I just said. If you're not a theory person, you're like, what the fuck is he talking about? F7, B flat, right? You can play, that's your A flat. I play the 7 because it resolves down to the next 7, right? You don't play B flat 7. That doesn't resolve correctly. But A flat 7, that dissonance isn't having parallel fifths, so you're good. There are parallel whatever octaves. So that's the chords. C minor, B flat, E flat 7, A flat 7, D7, G7. And then the coro is F minor. And I like to play boleros consistently, right? I think the recordings, people hear them and they think, oh, they're supposed to be played in and out of time, a little rushed, a little slow. You know, how many vihuela players or guitar players out there play with another vihuela player or guitar player on the opposite side? And they're always like speeding things up, or they're always slowing things down. How frustrating is that for you guys? Because it drives me crazy, right? I like a consistent time. So, right? Stay on time. If you're gonna start on time, right? Stay on time. But you're gonna start fast. That sounds, it feels like that's kind of how it is, right? I guess it can be taste. Most musical directors that I've played with and played for and worked for and been hired by, they all want me to play shit in time. So, you know, I think most singers want things to be played in time because then they can sing without having to adjust their timing. They're already up there in front of everybody singing their ass off, and now they got to be worried about time. I mean, it's kind of inconsiderate, you know. So if you're going to play something, start it on time. That's all I'm saying. Nothing controversial here, okay? So that's the song. You can do it in A minor. Sometimes people sing this in A minor, a key down. That's just a transposition. So that might be another topic, is transposing songs and chords from my electric guitar. Again, my channel is pretty much dedicated to guitar. It's communal to both vihuela and golpe and bass, and it's understanding your scales, understanding your roots, your fifths, and everything in between. And then you get into songs. So, yeah, more videos, guys. I want to say thank you to everybody who is watching. My channel views keep just going up every month. Interaction is pretty cool. Sometimes I get people that, you know, want to, whatever, you know, sometimes YouTube is really weird about comments. So I don't know if it's the world we live in today where YouTube feels like they have to curate all of people's comments, whether they're good, bad, or indifferent. But like, I don't always get your guys' comments. YouTube kind of holds shit like behind. I don't even see it unless I go look for it. So sometimes when you leave me comments in Spanish, YouTube is like, well, that's Spanish, so whatever. And it doesn't even show it to me. Sometimes it does. Sometimes it translates it into English for me. I'm like, Jesus, YouTube, what are you doing? I can read, write, speak, and fart both languages, okay? I don't need you to get involved. You can just kick back. If I need you, I'll come get you, but just fucking kick back otherwise. So I don't always get your comments. The comments that I have been getting, thanks for leaving comments, interacting with me, and, you know, talking trash. It's all kinds of fun. I'm from Tucson, so, you know, nothing that anybody says is really gonna, you know, shock me at this point. But yeah, just trying to keep my chops here. I love the song. It's a great, you know, arrangement. It's great at gigs. I love the singer, Javier Solis. He's like one of my favorite mariachi singers next to like fucking Gente. So like those two are like right at the top for me, as far as being able to listen to mariachi and enjoy it. So I love modern recordings and performances of these songs. But again, just gotta keep in mind the time, you know, the dynamic. The transitions between chords. So you don't want to play, you know, try to reduce that, like playing open strings or slowing the beat down, because I feel like part of why this song goes out of time is because how there's no rests in the song, but you see how people are taking like a 16th or an eighth of a rest. That's a pretty big rest where you're not playing on time, right? And you're still playing all of the eighth notes, right? Right? Even if you're going to play it like that, where you're just really stiff on the board and you're missing some of the strings, if you're going to play it like that, play it like that, but play it in time. It's not the end of the world. If you take an extra 16th or 8th rest, that's bad, okay? Try to practice to where you're not playing rests where there are no rests in the song. It's all just a steady stream of 8th notes, right? Bum, 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 bum. You know, try to get your hands used to that. Right, and again, if you don't like the criticism, then you're okay. I don't know how you made it through this long in the video, but yeah. So again, thank you guys. I'm gonna do some more videos today. We're gonna talk about diminished chords. And how they're used, how to read them. And yeah, more videos. It's 2021, guys. I'm still not playing gigs, we're just doing videos. So we'll see you guys back. And hopefully I do a Play My Electric podcast soon. I don't know. We'll see. That's kind of been really difficult to do. And I don't like Zoom. So maybe someday soon. So we'll see. All right. Later, guys.